Hi, this is CADCAM Lessons channel, and this is the next part of the FreeCAD Beginner's Guide, where I demonstrate basic concepts related to creating 3D models in this system. Link to the other parts of this tutorial are in the description of this video. FreeCAD is a completely free 3D CAD system where you can create your own 3D models, for example for 3D printing or collaboration with other CAD/CAM systems and people. FreeCAD allows you to save files in the STEP format, which is a universal data exchange format between different CAD/CAM systems. And when starting with FreeCAD, beginners sometimes encounter situations that can discourage further learning. However, if we understand the principles of working with FreeCAD, then working with FreeCAD can be much more enjoyable and smoother. The topics I will present may change over time as FreeCAD is constantly being developed and updated. The development team is continuously working on improving this system, regularly introducing fixes to make FreeCAD even more user-friendly and enjoyable. And one important aspect of creating 3D models in the part design module is that when working on a single body, the object is a single solid. If I create a sketch, I can create a single solid from it. Based on this geometry, I can create a 3D solid and everything works correctly. However, if we want to create two separate solids from a sketch, okay, it won't be possible because the geometry must be for creating a single part. Now I will edit a sketch and change it a bit. For example, we can create something like this. Although we have two separate shapes, this geometry allows us to obtain a single solid. Okay, I can edit sketch. I can create another shape here, for example, like this. Okay, and from this I also can create a 3D solid. Okay. But if you wanted to create something like this, where there is another geometry inside the hole, it wouldn't be possible. While displayed with holes is possible, the other geometry inside the hole isn't. If I try to create the extrusion, I can't do it. Let's edit sketch again and remove this geometry. Okay, and if I create intersecting geometries, for example, like this, a sketch is also not valid and I can't create a 3D solid from this sketch. Okay, let's edit sketch again. And one important aspect is that geometries in the sketch cannot intersect, and based on the geometry, we create a single solid. This is the way of working in the part design module, where a body is a single solid. Now, based on this sketch, I will create a solid. Okay, and add another sketch on this face. And let's create any sketch. I will create a sketch, for example, like this. Okay. And add another extrusion. Okay. Then I create another sketch. And add another extrusion. Okay. And as you can see, we can gradually create a 3D model, and in the part design module, we work in such a way that subsequent operations are added one after another. We see this in the operation tree. We have a clear history of operations, and we can also make changes to previous operations. For example, we can edit the length of the extrusion. Okay, and we can also change the dimensions of the first sketch. For example, like this. Okay. This is very convenient and useful because if we design a part and later need to make slight dimension changes, we can easily do it. And we can do the same with another sketch. We can change the dimensions. Okay. And these changes are allowed. However, if we want to completely change the sketch, for example, by creating another shape. Okay, close the sketch. Errors appear in subsequent operations. And the message appears that the part requires refreshing. And even though I click refresh, nothing changes. The geometry created in the sketch is not visible in the model. And making such changes in sketches, creating additional geometry or removing existing ones, is not allowed. We can change sketch dimensions, but not edit geometries already created, because changing the sketch geometry used in previous stages of creating the 3D solid can damage the entire 3D solid. This may be fixed in the future, but for now, remember not to make such changes in sketches. And when it comes to basic issues related to creating 3D solids in FreeCAD, it's worth noting one thing that often confuses beginners. It's about this line. Beginners may think these two parts of the 3D solid are separate solids, however, it's still one single solid, just with visible line. This line can be easily turned off. Select the last operation and change the refine parameter from false to true. Now the joint line is not visible. And you can enable this setting in preferences. Choose edit preferences. Select part design. And those settings will automatically change the parameter value from false to true, and the joint lines won't be visible. I will leave these settings unchecked, but they control the refine parameter value. And this was another important aspect to consider when learning FreeCAD. These issues often cause slight confusion among beginners, but if we understand and accept these limitations, FreeCAD can be a really interesting tool. These are some basic points I wanted to highlight. They may be improved soon, but for now, remember them. That's all for today. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to this channel.